At that time, we didn't even have a formal. It has a few organizations. At that time, the CT program, which was hosted at AMCAN, regional office. Mm-hmm. Then there was Kitwecha Sharia. Then there was Medinol, Fathers. There was Kogoni, Father Alex. So we used to meet at this strategies, what we do. Many times, the communities would be referred to Kitwecha Sharia, where they would feel the first thing they would do is to file an injunction over the evictions. So that is how, at that time also, Father Alex of Korogosho started, he started with that caucus. He got a few people from NGO World and the church, and we would meet once a month at the brothers, the Kogoni brothers, and we deliberate on the issues of informal settlement, the issues of urban poor. That's how it started. One of my colleagues, Biruri, who had trained in the second batch, was contacted. He was the one, because we were in the training, he was the one going to all the slums mostly, creating some awareness with the other colleagues. Then later, after our graduation, Rawlins Sapio joined him. Actually, Rawlins was directly assigned to be meeting with the communities who have threats of evictions. So he would meet, and we formed a committee that was supportive of him. So many times I used to support what he's doing, and especially in the strategy development. We used to strategize how do we go about the case. So there are many meetings we attended with him, and even prevented a lot of evictions. We were joined also by David Aramba. He's the one who used to document cases. He used to document the case. If it is a slum, he could document and put it down. So he has a lot of documentation.
Mm-hmm.
And we would meet and discuss each cases. So it actually began around that time, 1985, because that's the first meetings that we had. And I remember the person who organized the first meeting was Biruri,
okay,
which we attended, together with the NGO Council, I think. In community organization, we say we start with simple issues, but the main issue is the land. If we are to help in the urban poor, we have to help them acquire land, get security of tenure. And that's how the land caucus came about. We didn't have any money or any project or anything. So we could just discuss case by case. Many times, Kitwecha Sharia would represent and find injunctions. But eventually, most of the cases were thrown out because of bad laws. So there were, they really had a lot of cases. The land caucus was actually constituted by Father Alex.
Okay.
He's the one who brought the idea, but he's the one who was inviting people.
Mm-hmm.
He was the one who would point out at some people and ask them to attend.
Mm-hmm.
That's how he got involved. Mm-hmm. He would attend. Usually it was the evening, evening meeting at the brother's house.
Okay.
And we would stay there for about 2 hours discussing. It develops. It is out of him as a person who came in. The others just contributed, and so